Hey David, this is David Kwon. 13 years, or about 13 years from your time, since I'm almost 26, and you're 13 years old, which is amazing. You're actually almost 14, so I would say this is going to be almost, 12 years from now. You're about 13 and 10 months old, which is interesting. But yeah, Metal Gear Solid. Metal Gear Solid 4, we have Metal Gear Solid 4 now. We have a lot of games in the Metal Gear Solid series, which is pretty interesting. It's the game that changed your life. I know that makes it sound really overly dramatic. It's not as dramatic as that sounds, but to you at this point, it's kind of true. It is a game that does have a really profound impact on you. It's the game that drives you to be this creative person. It sparks a sort of creativity in you. And it's interesting that the thing that does that is a video game. It's also ironic that Metal Gear Solid is a game, it's an iconic PlayStation game, but you didn't play on the PlayStation. You played on a computer. You played a PC version called Metal Gear Solid Integral, which contains both Metal Gear Solid and Metal Gear Solid VR missions as in one package. It's also really interesting how you came to this game. You are a big PC gamer. You are a big PC gamer. Sorry, whenever you play something, you play on your PC. And you're a very casual type of gamer. I know you don't play that much. You don't play that frequently. But when you do, it's on the computer. And you like, for some reason, as a 13-year-old, you seem to like really complex games, like Age of Empires, and flight simulators like Silent Thunder, A-10, Warthog 2, which is a flying game, a comp about the A-10, the plane. So, very interesting stuff, but it is also really interesting that as a PC gamer, you used to visit PCGamerWorld.com because Dad didn't really allow you to buy anything, so you just downloaded demos, and you just played the hell out of demos. You came across this demo of Metal Gear Solid, and you loved it so much that you played it over 20 times until finally you realized you have to get this game somehow. And you went with your friend, and your friend and you with his mom go to this game store in a mall, and because his mom is there, it's rated M. So, if you and your friend went by yourself, there's no way you could get the game because they would card you and you would not get the game. But his mom was there. You bought the game, the PC version, you played it, you were amazed, and it just blew you away, and it changed your life. It changed your life because it made you creative enough to write this novel. So you asked this question, you asked some questions about this novel you wrote. It's a fun thing that you do, and I just think, and I just hope you just consider it as that, because honestly, you're going to try hard. That novel becomes, you end up writing a sequel to that novel, you end up writing a sequel to that sequel, so it becomes a trilogy, which I think is pretty amazing. I don't have the copies of the sequels. I don't know where Armageddon went, and I don't know where, what's the other name of that, Revelation went. So I don't know where the two manuscripts went. It's not saved in any of my computers or hard drives. Those two sequels that you write are totally gone in my time. I don't have any access to them. I do have a saved copy of, a digital copy of what you first initially titled as The Tempest, Beginning of the End. I changed the title later on because I think it fits better. I changed the title to As Long As You Fly. It's an interesting manuscript. You were heavily inspired by Metal Gear Solid. It some parts feel like you're kind of ripping off ideas from the game. So it's interesting. It's a very interesting story, but is it doable? Is it publishable? No, it's not. It's really horribly written. It has a lot of interesting set pieces here and there, but it's badly written, badly edited, because I end up rewriting that thing multiple times, and it gets better and better and better. Until eventually I give up on it, and it's kind of if I go back to the digital copy right now, it's going to be pretty solid writing to up to the, like, I don't know, chapter 7. After chapter 7, I gave up on rewriting the thing. After that, it falls apart again. It's just a mess of a writing. But I think it's important to point out that I still have a drive to write creatively. It takes a while. From when I entered college, I wrote a short story. It's a very cheesy teenage romance story. It's pretty horrible, actually. I write that, and then I stop creative writing for a while. During college, all I write are essays, nonfiction research papers, and after that, pretty much online blogs and just opinion pieces. I stopped writing creative fiction for a good amount of time. And then I returned back to it about 2 years ago, a year and a half ago, I would say. Very recent, actually. So there is a big hiatus from where you just stop writing creatively. And it's going back to it is a really difficult process. I remember, you know, you were able to, you created that, you know, 200-page novel in, like, I don't know, a 4-month span, which is amazing because 3 years ago, you know, when you were 10 years old, you didn't even know the alphabets that well. So, like I said, it's pretty amazing what kind of kid you are, really. But I do lose that creative drive for a long time. I'm still trying to recover it. I'm writing some short stories in here and there. But I think a lot of my creative ideas currently are really morbid. I end up writing these really dark stories. That could be, you know, it would be rated R if it was made into a movie. So that's kind of where I'm at right now. I'm still trying to kind of, you know, get the creative juices flowing. But you, as a 13-year-old, are definitely more creative than me. You just need to work on your writing because your writing skills kind of suck. But I know you're gonna work hard at it. You're a very, very studious, very nerdy kid. Up till you hit 7th grade, I think. Then you kind of hit a downturn after that. But it's good to know that, you know, you have this newfound creative drive about writing, which you never had before you played Metal Gear Solid. So it's really interesting how that game changes your life. It's also good to know, currently, we're not talking about Metal Gear Solid 5. That's the future, man. It's pretty crazy how much this series comes. And it's because it has such a profound effect on your life, I think maybe that's why, you develop such a fanboyism for this franchise. It's pretty interesting how that happens to be. But yeah, keep at it. Enjoy writing. Try not to lose your creative spark. Try to keep it as long as you can. Don't worry about publishing. Don't worry about becoming famous or whatever, because you won't be. It's not publishable. It's not doable, okay? You making out as a writer, a living as a writer, not gonna happen. Not really possible. Don't think about that. Just enjoy it. Just enjoy writing. Just be creative. And that's really all I want to say. All right, cheers.